Hello everyone, this is your accounting coach ARD and the topic that I've brought for you today is control accounts. Now before trying to understand what does a control account means, firstly we need to understand what is a ledger. I hope most of you have already studied in your earlier studies that ledger is a book containing T accounts. So any book that contains T accounts is known as ledger. So the ledgers can be classified into three categories. One is sales ledger, another one is purchase ledger, and the third one is general ledger, also known as a nominal ledger. Now what is the difference between the two in the three? First of all, sales ledger. Sales ledger basically contain all debtor accounts. For example, if we have three customers, one is Mr. A, then we have Mr. B, then we have Mr. C. So Mr. A's, B's and C's, all of these three T accounts that are also known as personal accounts would be kept in a sales ledger. Then we have a purchase ledger which contains supplier accounts. For example, we have three suppliers. One is Mr. X, another one is Mr. Y and the third one is Mr. Z. So all of the supplier T accounts would be kept in a purchase ledger. Then last but not the least, we have a general ledger. General ledger, my dear students, contain all of the T accounts other than customer and supplier, because all the customers, credit customers are there in sales ledger, all the credit suppliers are in purchase ledger, and all other accounts other than customer and supplier are kept in a general ledger, such as sales account, such as purchase account, cash, bank, asset, liability, income, expense, all other accounts other than debtor and creditor. But what we are worried about, what we are concerned about today is two specific T accounts known as SLCA, stand for sales ledger control account, and PLCA, stand for purchase ledger control account. So we are basically worried about these two accounts. So the question here arises that, sir, if we already have separate T account for all of the customers, why there is a need to make a separate account for all the customers combined? Now the answer to this question is that if we are making individual accounts and we are not making a control accounts, there can be chances of error or fraud. If there is any error in sales ledger, there is no way to find out whether these sales ledger balances are correct. So in order to keep a check on the sales and purchase ledgers, we make combined account for all debtors known as sales ledger control account and combined account for all the creditors known as purchase ledger control account. Because these individual accounts, sales and purchase ledger, are maintained by separate personnel in the organization, and these control accounts are being made by a separate person, in this case due to segregation of duties, there would be very less chance that any type of error or fraud could occur. Now let's move on to sales ledger control account first. Sales ledger control account, dear students, is basically all customers combined account. It is a combined account for all the customers. If you are making a control account, we'll be starting with a balance brought down, and normally for this, SLCA is an abbreviation for sales ledger control account. We'll be starting with opening balance. For example, I am making a control account for 1 year, that is 2020. It can be made for 1 month, it can be made for 6 months, and so on. For example, if I'm making for the whole year, so the balance brought down would normally come on the debit side. Why? Because it is basically a debtor account. Debtor is a customer. Customer is an asset for the organization. So the balance brought down would come on the debit side. If the balance brought down is on debit side, so balance carried down would should come on the opposite side, that it is closing balance. Okay. So these are the two balances. This is opening and this is closing. Now these are the normal balances. Other than the normal balances, a control account can contain abnormal balances, and these abnormal balances are termed as minority balances. What does a minority balance means, my dear students? Minority balance means that normally our customers owe us the money. Minority balance means there are some customers, there are few of the customers who have paid us more than that they actually owe us. and the extra amount that they have paid us is in a minority balance for us, for the organization, because it is a credit balance. It is a liability for the business. Okay. Now, what are the reasons for minority balance? One reason that I've just mentioned, that customer has paid for more than he or she owes us. Secondly, it can be customer has paid us duplicate payment by error. Firstly, they paid us the balance that they owe, that is $1,000. And secondly, they thought that they have not yet paid the balance. They paid this balance again. So if they have paid the same balance two times, and now we have to return the extra amount of money that we have received from the customer, though this is known as minority balance. And the third reason for minority balance is that customer has bought the goods from us on credit, and customer has already paid for these goods, and then the customer decides to return the goods because they are faulty. The customer has not yet checked it earlier. If it would have checked it earlier, he or she would not have paid us in the first time. Okay. So if the customer has returned the goods to us, now we are supposed to return the customer the money that he have actually paid for. Okay. So this is known as a minority balance. So my dear student, this is basically a credit balance. Therefore, it is coming on the credit side. So if the credit balance, balance brought down is coming on the credit side, so balance carried down would come on the debit side. Okay. If opening balance is coming on the credit side, then the closing balance would come on the debit side. As you may be aware, always balance CDs are reversed. If the normal opening balance is coming on the debit side, so the closing balance would come on the opposite side. If the normal minority balance or credit balance is coming on the credit side, then the closing balance would always come on the debit side. Now we have some transactions to discuss. First of all, there is credit sales. Whenever we sell goods on credit, the entry would be sales account would be credited and customer's account would be debited. So this is not a sales account, basically this is a customer's account. Okay, so the customers would be debited and the reference would be sales. As you may be aware, my dear students, whenever we debit an account, the reference that we use is for the account that should have been credited, or vice versa. And now the second transaction is, whenever customers pay us the money, the entry would be cash or bank would be debited and a debtor account would be credited. Now I'm crediting the debtor account and the reference would be bank. Okay. So there's no need to put dates in front of every transaction, because all of these transactions belong to end of the period, that is end of the year in my case. So I'll be only putting 31st December once at a debit side and once at a credit side. Now there are some further transactions to discuss. Then we have a discount allowed whenever our customers pay us earlier than we have allowed them. So if they are paying prompt payment to us, now we are supposed to pay them some discount. This is a cash discount known as discount allowed. So discount allowed would basically reduce our debtor, and the entry would be debt, discount allowed would be debited and SLC account would be credited. Now we have return inwards, also known as sales return. Whenever we have sold the goods to customer on credit and the customer return those goods because these are faulty or they are of wrong size or color or specification, so this would be sales return or return inward. The entry would be return inward account would be debited and a customer account, debtor account would be credited. Then we have a bad debt. Bad debt is also known as irrecoverable debt. Whenever the customer do not pay us the amount that he or she owes us, this would be a bad debt. So bad debt is basically an expense. The entry would be bad debt account debit and a debtor account would be credited. Then we have a contra adjustment. What does this contra adjustment means? Contra adjustment is like that. There is a customer, for example, Mr. A, and he buys goods from me. Then the customer Mr. A also become my supplier. How? Because we also bought some goods in need from him on credit. So now we also owe to Mr. A, and customer Mr. A also owes us the money. So rather than he paying us our money and we are paying a liability, we are paying off to him, we would cancel out the transaction altogether. So this is basically contra adjustment. For example, I owe Mr. A $500 and Mr. A owes me $800. So the lower amount would be $500. So the contra entry would be made with $500. So entry would be customer's account would be credited. Okay, SLC account would be credited and a supplier account, that is PLC account, would be debited. So the entry would be liability debit and debtor account would be credited. Asset would be credited and liability would be debited. So this is basically a customer's account. Customer's account would be credited with reference to contra PLCA. And if we are making a PLC account, that PLC account would be debited, reference would be contra SLCA. Okay, then we have some other transactions that, such as bank refund. Firstly, bank dishonored check. So what does a dishonored check means? Means the customer has paid us by check, but the bank of the customer has not honored his or her check. Why the bank has not honored the check? The obvious reasons are that the customer does not have any money in his bank account. Secondly, the check can be expired. More than 6 months have been passed when the check was written initially. So this is known as dishonored check. So whenever customer pays us the money, the entry is bank debit and debtor account would be credited. And now if the check is dishonored, the entry would be reversed. Our bank account would be credited and an SLCA or debtor account would be debited. Okay. So in order to differentiate between these two entries that are both with the bank, we'll be writing dishonored check in the brackets. Okay. Then we have interest charge. If our customers do not pay us on time, we can penalize them by charging a penalty, or also known as interest. So if we are charging penalty or interest from the customer, similarly schools do charge the students if they do not pay their fee challan on time. Okay, so this is a liability for the customer and this is an asset for the business. Entry would be SLCA or customer's account would be debited, and interest that we are charging to our customers is basically our income. So entry would be debtor account would be debited and interest income would be credited. Then we have last transaction, and that is refund. If some of our customers have paid us the amount more than that they actually owe us, now we ought to return that money to our customers. So whenever we'll be returning money to our customers, the entry would be cash or bank account would be credited and SLCA account would be debited. So why are we debiting the SLCA account? Because we are actually decreasing our liability. So this credit balance, this is a liability, and this minority balance is reduced when we'll be refunding the amount to our customers. So whenever the examiner is silent about the mode of payment, whether it is made through cash or bank, we'll be always writing bank. Okay, we will be never be writing cash unless and until it mentions the cash. So now we are balancing both of these figures. If all of the figures are given in an examination question, this would automatically balance. Or it can be that for example, balance carried down is not given. So what we'll be doing, we'll be adding up the debit side. This is the big, this would be the bigger side. If we write this the greater amount on both of the sides and deduct all of these items, we'll be getting a balance carried down. So this normal balance carried down would become balance brought down at the start of the next period. After 31st December 2020 will come 1st January 2021. So this is a normal balance brought down, and this credit balance which is coming on the debit side would become a credit balance once it is made as balance BD. Once it is become balance BD, this is a minority balance. So in an SLCA, my dear student, there will always be a normal balance, balance brought down, and a balance carried down. There can be minority balance, there can be one minority balance, there can be both balance BD or balance CD, or that can be none. Okay, so minority balance can be there or cannot be there, but the majority balance would always be there. Now after SLCA, let's discuss PLCA, that is Purchase Ledger Control Account. My dear students, Purchase Ledger Control Account is basically a combined account for all of the creditors. Okay, it is a single account that contain all of the creditor balances, that is our suppliers. So as you may be aware, that creditor is basically a liability for the business. Because we have bought goods on credit from the supplier, now we are supposed to pay that money to the suppliers. So the short form or the abbreviation is PLCA for Purchase Ledger Control Account. So normally balance brought down would come on the credit side because it is a liability for the business. If balance BD is coming on the credit side, then the balance carried down should come on the opposite side, that is debit side. So there can be a minority balance in a PLCA as well. So why is there a minority balance? Why can be a minority balance in a PLCA? Because we have made a paid our suppliers two times. We have made some duplicate payment to our suppliers, because if we have paid supplier two times, so now we expect that a supplier will return us the amount that we have paid him extra. Okay, so this is a minority balance. Another reason for minority balance can be that we have paid our supplier an advance but not yet bought the goods from him or her. So the amount that we have paid as an advance, if we have not bought the goods, so we will expect that the supplier will return our advance to us. So this is basically a minority balance. And the third reason can be that we have bought goods on credit and we have also paid for that goods, and then finally we have returned that goods to a supplier. Now if we have returned the goods for which we have already paid, now we will be expecting that our supplier will return this money to us. So this is a minority balance, this is a debit balance. Okay, so if the opening debit balance is coming on the debit side, then closing debit balance would come on the opposite side. As you must be aware, always the balance CD always switch the sides, and balance CD always come on the opposite side. Then we have some transactions. First of all, we have a purchase. Whenever we buy goods on credit, liability would increase. The entry would be purchase account would be debited and a liability account would be credited. So this is basically not a purchase account, this is basically a liability account. So the purchase account would have been debited and a liability account, this is a creditor account, would be credited. Then whenever we pay our suppliers, the liability that we owe to them, liability would reduce, entry would be bank account would be credited, or alternatively if we are paying through cash, cash account would be credited and liability account would be debited. But if the examiner does not mentions in the question that we have paid through check or cash, will be always be writing bank, not the cash. Then we have a discount received whenever we pay our supplier earlier than he has given us the time to pay. So for prompt payment, our supplier will be giving us some sort of discount, cash discount, also known as discount receive. So this discount receive is basically income for us and it will reduce our liability. So the entry would be liability account would be debited and discount receive account would be credited. Then we have a return outward account. Whenever we are returning goods to a supplier, these are known as return outward, also known as purchase return. So whenever we are returning goods to a supplier, the entry would be liability would be debited and return outward account would be credited. Then we have a contra transaction. We already discussed contra earlier, that a contra transaction means that we are buying from or selling to a same customer. Okay, it can be an individual or it can be a business. So rather than we expect that he or she pay us the money and we pay them the amount that we owe, so we would rather prefer to cancel out the transaction, and this is known as a contra transaction. So in a contra transaction, both debtor and creditor are decreased by the same amount, that is the lower amount. So the entry would be SLCA would be credited and PLCA would be debited. So PLCA would be debited, reference would be contra SLCA, and an SLCA would be credited, reference would be contra PLCA. Okay, then we have interest charge. If we do not pay our suppliers on time, our suppliers are subject to charge, are supposed to charge liability, they will be charging us with extra amount. The penalty would be interest charge. So because of this penalty, now we have to pay them more than the amount that we actually owed. So the entry would be interest expense would be debited and liability account would be credited. Then we have bank refund. For example, if we have paid our supplier more than the amount we actually owe to them, then the extra amount that they are refunding to us would be bank account would be debited, cash or bank would be debited, and PLCA account would be credited. Now why is PLCA being credited? Because the minority balance that is coming on the debit side, this is the asset, and whenever our supplier will return us the amount that they owe to us, this will reduce our asset. Okay, so now let us balance this. If we balance this, if all of the transactions are given, the T account should always balance. Or alternatively, there can be a situation where balance CD is missing, or there can be balance CDs are there and the purchase account is missing. So whatever amount is missing, you can find out unless and until that all other amounts are given to you. So in a PLCA, there will always be a normal balance BD and a normal balance CD. This is a liability, but there can be or there cannot be a minority balance. A minority balance can be there or it cannot be there. If a minority balance is coming on the debit side, so if the balance brought down is coming on the debit side, then the balance carried down would be coming on the credit side. Now, if I close this, this balance carried down should become balance brought down at the next of second accounting period after December 2020 would come January 2021. So this would become balance BD, and this balance carried down, that is debit balance, would come on that debit side. So for this also CIE award you marks for 1 mark for doing for balance brought down. So I hope you were able to understand the concepts behind a control account. We discussed what does a control account means, and there are two types of control accounts, namely sales ledger control account and a purchase ledger control account. We also discussed what are minority balances, and we also discussed the differences between a sales ledger and a sales ledger control account. Sales ledgers were basically individual or personal accounts of customers, and sales ledger control account is a T account containing all of the customers' balances. Then we have purchase ledger. Purchase ledger were basically individual account for all our suppliers, and purchase ledger control account was a combined account for all our suppliers. Now, my dear students, if you did benefited from this video, kindly do share it and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so. Thank you.